Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn about the fabrication of short labial bow in Pedodontics. So basically the short labial bow is the one that extends from one canine to other canine in the same arch. Basically this labial bow we will be giving a step by step demonstration. So the things that we require is the marking pencil, we require a marker pen, then we require a universal plier, then we require a hard wire cutter, then we require a round 21 gauge stainless steel wire. This is hard round 21 gauge stainless steel wire, and we require an ideal cast or a patient cast. This is an ideal cast where we will go step by step. So in this first step we will do some markings. So we will divide this tooth, central incisors, lateral incisors, into three parts. That is, by drawing a horizontal line over the central incisor, dividing the tooth into three parts, three equal halves. Now this line, the first line we are dividing it, is dividing the tooth into the incisal third and the middle third. And then this second line is dividing the middle third, or separating the middle third from the cervical third. So our bow would be resting at the junction of the incisal and the middle third. So this upper line would be where the bow would be resting. Now extending this horizontal line, upper line, up to the medial third of the canine, covering both the lateral incisors, as you can see over here. Now we need to divide the canine also into three equal halves, but into the medial third, the middle third, and the distal third. So the U-loops would be starting at the medial third of the canine on both the sides, and its extension would be, or height of the U-loop would be, at the 1 to 2 mm below the cervical line of the canine, or we can say at the crest of the bone. Similarly on the other side. So these markings will help us to avoid any errors, and we can fabricate based on these markings, so we will be able to do it in a proper way. So after finishing these markings, we can begin with the wire bendings. So let's begin with our second step. Now our second step involves taking out a 21 gauge wire and cutting it into a desired length. So these wires are provided in the form of a spool, so we need to cut the desired length. And in the fabrication of short labial bow, we need roughly around 5 to 7 centimeters of wire, so we need to cut it with the help of a wire cutter. Now we can see that we have a 5 to 7 centimeters of this wire. Now this wire is in the form of a roughly a curvature, but we need to adapt it according to the arch form that is in the cast. So we need to adapt it for the most prominent teeth, that is the incisors and the canines. It should be touching the incisors and the canines. So with the use of our finger and thumb pressure, we can form an arch form like this. Remember not to give any sharp bends. We can begin from one end and end to the other end with the help of our finger pressure like this, as you can see. This way we will form an arch that is similar to the arch in the cast, and we can check for its adaptation, whether it is touching the most prominent teeth, that is the incisors. Now here we can see it is touching the incisors but not canine at one end, so we need to give slight modifications, and remember not to distort the plane of this wire while forming the arch. Now you can see that incisors are being touched, and the same way canine on both the ends, on both the sides of the canines are being touched. So we can now give some reference markings. This is the central marking, and these are the medial third markings on the two canines. So these were our reference marking, and remember to keep the plane of the wire always set. Now in this third step, what we need to do is we need to give the sharp 90 degree bends, but before that we should always make sure that the plane is perfectly fine. Now holding it with the help of the universal plier, with the broad flat end of the universal plier and one end, as you can see in this, and keeping the plane same, we need to give a sharp 90 degree bend. We should hold very firmly with the help of plier, otherwise the wire would distort and all the plane would distort. Like this we have given a sharp 90 degree bend. Again at the other medial third marking we need to give again a sharp 90 degree bend by holding the plier very firmly against the wire, keeping the plane same and bending it completely 90 degree. Now this completes our third step. Now let's begin with our fourth step. In this fourth step, we will give or form the U-loops. So for the formation of these U-loops, we need to first mark the height of these U-loops. Now we can check its adaptation. The adaptation of the bow is perfectly fine up to the medial third of the canine on both the sides, as you can see. So now we can go for the height of the U-loops. So for that, we will place it on the canine and mark the height up to the tip of the canine on both the sides, as you can see that. This would mark our height of the U-loop. So we are marking two points like this. Now this has marked the height of the U-loops. Now we need to give the U-loop bendings. So what we will do is we will take our universal plier and the most smaller rounded part, as you can see that, we will engage that smaller rounded part of the universal plier, and keeping the arc form we will hold it in the same plane in one complete go, as you can see that, without distorting, in a complete arc form. This forms a U-loop in one segment, and again engaging the plier, the narrowest circular part of this universal plier, following the arch of the bow and completing the second loop. So we need to open it, these loops, so that it looks like a U-loop. So this completes our fourth step. Now let's begin with our fifth step. In this step we are first checking the adaptation. When adaptation is fine, now we need to give a palatal adaptation for the retentive arms, this arm. So we will go one by one. First we will adapt one arm to the palate, then for the second arm. So we will mark the height for the embrasure where we would be giving the bend, and as you can see we have marked the point. Now we need to give a sharp 90 degree bend at this end. So we will hold this with the round beak of the plier at most tip part of this plier, universal plier, and give it a complete bend. Now we will check for its adaptation on the cast. Now you can see that it is perfectly adapted on the cast. And similarly for the opposite side, we need to again do a marking at the embrasure point like this, and now we need to engage it into the beak of the universal plier. Now we need to engage it in the beak of this universal plier and again give a sharp bend like this, and now we can check its adaptation on the cast. In this step, we need to check the palatal adaptation on the cast. So we need to check 2 to 3 things. One is the palatal adaptation of the retentive arms. Second thing is the bow should be passive, it should not have any springing action. And the third thing is that the bow should be touching the most prominent teeth, that is the incisors and the canine. And the U-loop should be resting on the crest of the bone below the canines. So having a passive fit of the labial bow is a must. Now we can begin with the tegum part of the retentive arms. In this step, we are going to fabricate the tegums of the retentive arms. So we need to engage the ends in the beak of the universal plier and roll it in one go, and then give a compression by the flat end of the universal plier like this, engaging it into the grooves of the universal plier and giving a compression. Similarly, for the other retentive arm, we again engage it in the beak of the plier with giving a round and then compressing it with the flat ends. Like this, we need to engage it into the grooves and then give a compressive bend. So this completes the tegum part of the labial bow. Now in this last step, we need to check for the final adaptation and remove errors if there are any. So now we will check it on the cast. Now the bow is touching the most prominent teeth. However, there is a slight lack of palatal adaptation in one of the retentive arms, and one of the canine segment is not touching. One of the U-loops in the canine segment is not touching. So we need to modify, give a little bend at one retentive arm. So these are the minor corrections that we should not overlook, and give a final correction bends like this, and one slight modification at the U-loop. This would complete our final labial bow.